You're watching News 24 Live. Welcome to another episode of our Rugby World Cup show, where today we are going to be focusing on the Springbok midfield after the departure of Captain Jean de Villiers. And we've got just the man to comment on that. Former Springbok centre Peter Miller has graced our studio today. Peter, thanks very much for coming in. It's great to have you here. You're now a Capetonian, I believe, after obviously spending a lot of years up in Natal. Like I said in my intro, Jean de Villiers' departure, I guess a lot of us are not that surprised. And we know what a great leader and what a great player he was. But then it does now give opportunity to some real exciting youngsters to put up their hands in the midfield. What's your take on the Springbok midfield?
Nick, yeah, I think you know, it's sad for Jean, you know, for again in the World Cup getting injured, you know. But it's like they always say, you know, sometimes, you know, with somebody going out, something new comes in, you know. And, you know, I think we're going to lose a great leader by Jean, but at the same time, we're getting youth. We're getting two exciting centre pairings. And I think, you know, it just, it for me, it's exciting. I think going forward, it will be, will help us in the quarterfinals, you know, and having that youth will also just give us a little bit of an edge. You know, a lot of teams haven't seen much of them. So, well, you know, that's what we have to wait and see for.
Now, of course, they've called up Jan Serfontein as cover. A lot of people feeling that Frans Steyn was sort of hard done by there. Do you think he was the right call-up as a replacement centre?
Nick, you can't say he's the wrong call-up because I think Heineke's got his own ideas where what he wants to do with him. My only opinion is I think Frans gives you a bit more. You know, he's a utility back. He can give you can play fly half, centre, full back. You know, it just gives you a bit more variation there. I would have gone for France. You know, he's a big guy. He's played World Cups, and even if he's maybe a bit underdone at the moment, you know, maybe fitness-wise, you know, I would have still given him. I think he would perform at that level.
Mm-hmm. Now, Peter, you played 33 tests, if I'm not mistaken, for the Springboks. Your last game at the 99 World Cup, which was also in the UK. Have you been following this World Cup closely, and has it sort of brought back some old memories for you?
Yeah, I have been watching it, you know. Me and Stefan de Blanche and a couple of other ex-players involved in a bit of a betting at the moment, so we have to do it that way. But yes, from a personal point of view, yes, I do watch it, you know. I try to watch most of the games. I think it's an interesting World Cup this year. There's no... You can't say that somebody is standing out. I know the All Blacks are doing well and consistently, but they're also vulnerable. We've seen it against Argentina. So I think it's a very open World Cup this year.
And as we saw, of course, in the Springboks' first game, the minnows are catching up in world rugby. Has that been quite surprising for you?
It has been. I think if you look at America playing Scotland, I think small little details that, you know, the smaller unions just... They can surpass that, I think, you know, then like the ill discipline and just making the less mistakes or the handling mistakes. I think they're close there, you know. Romania, a lot of them are picking up. You can see there's some step up from the last 4 years.
So now, do you feel the box have sort of turned the corner, put that Japan game behind them, on are still sort of World Cup contenders?
Nick, yeah, you have to. I think we had a bad one, you know. It's just one of them where I think we... we're not focused on that game. If you compare the two games, you know, the Japanese game, you know, the guys were lackadaisy and looking at this way, were focused. As they walk out, you could see they were right for it. You know, when you see Skalk Berger, don't smile before a game, then you know he's serious about the game. So I think we are, you know, it just depends, again, you know, can we keep that focus for the Scotland game, the USA game, and then afterwards to the quarterfinals, that's when it's going to start, you know. And I think then it's, you know, knockout stages, you have to win your game. So but yeah, we're there. I think it just depends what happened. The other pools, you know, maybe get a bit of a easier run, but it's not going to be easy in the quarterfinals.
I suppose the one good thing that did come out of that game against Japan was two bonus points for the box, which it actually might come down to in their pool B with Scotland on maximum points so far. How far do you think the box realistically can go? Bearing in mind, in the quarterfinals, they're facing someone from that pool of death, which is also interesting, because Wales, England, Australia, one of them's going home from that pool.
Yeah, I feel sorry, and I think if you're looking at just Wales, they're playing well at the moment, but somebody's going to go home, and England at the moment are looking shaky and being the host union. You know, that could be the surprise, you know, that drop after the the pool rounds. But again, realistically, we have to look at the semi-final, final spot, you know, if we really play to our potential. But it's going to be hard, you know, to get now string about five games together. It's going to be hard, you know. I just don't know if we have the, we've got the experience, but do we have the feet to carry us that long, you know? That's what we have to wait and see.